This is a quick movie just showing you how to open up an OME or a non-supported multi-layer TIFF file inside Image Pro. OME is typically not supported at the moment, but it will be in versions of past 7.0, which is probably the time you may well be reading this. So first of all, just open up the file. It is a multi-layer TIFF, so it opens up very quickly. We can open up multiple gigs data of OMEs very fast. Here we have it, and we open it up, and if we play through it, we can see, actually, it's a mix-up of multiple images. So we've got multi-channel, Z-spacing, time, things like that. So we just have to normalize this. So we'll go to Set Manager, New, OK, and we'll just add that. And we'll say you have two channels, and we'll say you've got 20 Z positions, and we'll say you've got scan, well, they're actually time points, 10 time points. OK, and now I've got a controller. I can play through time, or I can play through Z at any particular time, and I can extract what I want. Now I can pretty much do anything I want from here. If I want to add information, I can do. So I can maybe add the emission wavelength, just because I want to do some deconvolution. So I'll say it's 500 nanometers, and I can say it's this channel's wavelength, or the whole stack's wavelength. In this case, it's the channel, and then I switch to a different channel, and I enter a value for that, so maybe I make that one 400. And I can set up the magnification, the refractive index, and maybe I come in here and say that, well, you know, that it was 100x, it was oil, and it was 1.4. Yep, and that's for every image in the entire set. Okay, so now maybe I want to just do a quick deconvolve. So I'll just come in here and say, okay, well, you know, actually, I'm going to say, actually, well, I didn't save that, so I'm going to say it's 1.4 Na, oil, 0.06, and I'll just deconvolve that very quickly with the nearest neighbor, and we'll just play through that. Better rescale that. Okay, and then you can see a bit of deconvolve data there. Okay, a little deblurred. If I wanted to, if I switched on time, I could come in, I could come and load up the whole thing as a time sequence. And again, here I have it here inside a 3D viewer that I can zoom around and make movies. And I can play through the time viewer here as well. If I wanted to, if anything moved, it would do. The other thing I could do is just quickly, well, just extract this time sequence. So now I have the movies as a time frame. Maybe I draw a region on here. And just added something up there, a region on there, and just do track intensity over time. Just pop up a little graph. Well, I have two intensities there, and you can shift that out to Excel if you want. Okay, I hope that helps. If you have any more questions, please ask your local sales office or dealer. Thanks.